I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me. In all my days, I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up till I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest nights, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you've been so faithful. You are so good. Crossing the calm sea with Jesus, the disciples were getting concerned. The wind started violently blowing, but he was asleep in the stern. Does he not care that we perish? We're helpless and we're so afraid. Jesus arose when they called him and said to them, where is your faith? Because you prayed all night, 'cause you held on with all of your might. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. Oh, he knows your voice. Lift your hands, it's time to rejoice. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. It hit you without any warning. The storm of your life had begun. Seeing no hope in the distance, you're frightened and nowhere to run. By now your vessel is filling, and you're thinking that you'll surely drown. You've cried out for help from the Savior, and you know you can't give up now, because you prayed all night, 'cause you held on with all of your might. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. Oh, he knows your voice. Lift your hands, it's time to rejoice. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. You're up there worrying, he's fast asleep. The winds are so deadly, the water's so deep. Try to be patient, 'cause soon he'll bring peace. Just one word from his voice and it all must cease. Because you prayed all night, 'cause you held on with all of your might. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. Oh, he knows your voice. Lift your hands, it's time to rejoice. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. Oh, he knows your voice.
And sing, and then when something goes wrong, it's scary. But I thought she handled that with such poise. She did so well. Now, I want to introduce, you know, Deanna and the girls, obviously, but I hope that in your life you have somebody like Glenn and Barb. Glenn and Barb have been in my life for 25 years now, and they have never been anything but good and kind to me. But more than that, they've been my biggest cheerleader from afar, and they couldn't be with us because they live in Nicholasville, and you know, that's where their life journey is, and we support them there. They both work for Asbury University, and Barb is a professor there, and Glenn is a vice president there, and they both do really well with that. But more than that, they love Jesus with everything in them. And, and the thing is, what you don't know is that while I was pastor and I was drowning, they were my life jacket. They checked on us all the time. And it meant the world to me to know that they cared and that they were supporting us. They sent us to conferences. They gave us the resources that we needed so that I could pastor effectively and to continue to minister to this very day. And a lot of the lessons that I learned from the resources that they provided for me have given us the ability to be here. And so if you like our church, if you like the direction that our church is going, a lot of it comes to them. And I know that they're going to say, no, 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 no. But I love when Jesus puts people together. And he's doing that right now. Again, I feel it. Do you all feel it? I do. And so I'm just very thankful that Glenn and Barb Hamilton are here with us to worship. And again, their journey's their own. And if they want to talk a little bit about it, that's fine. But for me, again, they have no idea how important they have been to me and to our family. So I love you all. And would you please welcome Glenn and Barb Hamilton?
Well, thank you all. We're honored to be here and to be in a long line of Hamilton and I'm not going to say them all because I'm going to leave somebody out, but the generations of this family. Brian and I often talk about how grateful we are to be grafted in, thanks to Deanna and Glenn. And we're just honored to be here, and I think the Holy Spirit picked all the songs today, from Aunt Brenda to Crystal. And so if God's been faithful to you, we want to invite you to sing with us today as soon as you can, and let's declare his promises over the generations of our family. Christ is my firm foundation. He's the rock on which I stand. When everything around me's shaking, I've never been more glad that I put my faith in Jesus. He's never let me down. He's faithful through generations. So why would he fail now? He won't. He won't. I've still got joy in chaos. I've got peace that makes no sense. So I won't be going under. I'm not held by my own strength. I build my life on Jesus. He's never let me down. He's faithful in every season. So why would he fail now? He won't. He won't. He won't fail. He won't fail. Christ is my firm foundation. He's the rock on which I stand. When everything around me's shaking, I've never been more glad. I put my faith in Jesus. Never let me down. He's faithful through generations. So why would he fail now? He won't.
He won't. He won't fail. He won't fail. He won't. Rain came, the winds blew, but my house was built on you. I'm safe with you. I'm gonna make it through. Rain came, wind blew, but my house was built on you. I'm safe with you. I'm gonna make it through. Sing it with us. Rain came, wind blew, but my house was built on you. I'm safe with you. I'm gonna make it through. I'm gonna make it through. 'Cause I'm standing strong on you. I'm gonna make it through. 'Cause my house is built on you. Christ is my firm foundation. He's the rock on which I stand. When everything around me is shaken, I've never been more glad. I put my faith in Jesus. He's never let me down. He's faithful through generations. So why would he fail now? He won't. He won't. He won't fail. He won't fail. Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be. It's always been you, Jesus. Jesus at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be. It's always been you, Jesus. Jesus. Nothing else matters. Nothing in this world will do. Jesus, you're the center. Everything revolves around you. Jesus, you. At the center of it all. Jesus, be the center of my life. Jesus, be the center of my life. From beginning to the end, it'll always be. It's always been you, Jesus.
Jesus, nothing else matters. Nothing in this world will do. Jesus, you're the center, and everything revolves around you. Jesus, you, from my heart to the heavens, Jesus, be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus, be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. Jesus, be the center of your church. Jesus, be the center of your church. Every knee will bow, and every tongue will confess you, Jesus. 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 Jesus.
So, I have a confession to make. I'm in awe of the Holy Spirit. That's my confession. You can go ahead and put the first slide up. Did we talk? Did we talk? We didn't talk. The girls in Deanna, I asked them to learn that song, Firm Foundation, for this message. And they said, we just can't do it, Dad. We don't have enough time to get it ready. But that's the way our Lord works. You know, in His time and in His way, everything comes together. And so I'm in awe of our God. You know, my message today is, why is a firm foundation important? And, you know, I go to the rock that's higher than I. We've all heard that over the years. And to get there, I have to get into His Word, because that's who Jesus is. The Bible tells us that He is the Word made flesh. And if you turn with me to Matthew 7, while you're turning there, it's Matthew 7, 24 through 27 is going to be our main scripture today. But I want you to know that in this, the preacher of preachers is giving his most significant message that he ever gave to the world, the Sermon on the Mount. And in the Sermon on the Mount, we see this beautiful picture of what the kingdom of heaven is and how it turns the way that we think the world should be on its head. And there's a top-down kingdom message. And so I want you to see that this is just the end of that. So I would love for all of us, if we could at some point over the next few weeks, go back and read Matthew 5, 6, and 7, and we can gain some knowledge and some context, okay? But Matthew 7, 24 through 27, it gives us this conclusion. This is how Jesus ended his most important sermon. It says, therefore, whosoever hears these things, these sayings of mine, and does them, I will liken him unto a wise man, which built his house upon a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. And everyone that hears these sayings of mine and does them not shall be likened unto a foolish man, which built his house upon the sand. And the rains came, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell. And great was the fall of it. And so, what I want you to see is that Jesus, he actually had a double expertise in this illustration, in this parable, in this analogy, whatever you want to call it. In this conclusion, he saw that there was this opportunity where he could talk not only about the expertise of the kingdom of heaven, but one that he had used his hands and labor over the course of his 30-some years of life. He knew what it was to build a house. Those of you all who have followed Jesus for many years, you all know he was a carpenter. He built things. He's building things still. He builds lives now. And so I want you to understand something. Those of you all who have built things, you all know that if you don't have the foundation right, it's not going to be right. Can I get an amen? All right, see, if I build something, it's going to look like this. You're going to have to go like this and look cockeyed at it, and it's going to be crooked. But now you know, you got somebody who knows what they're doing, and they square it up, it's going to be right, and it's going to be square. The thing about it is we need to understand that Jesus wants you to know that the foundation of your life is as important as anything else that you will ever have. If you don't get that right, your life is not going to be right. So your foundation, my friends, needs to be built on the solid rock. The solid rock is Jesus Christ and his teachings. If the foundation is right, though, your structure will stand the test of time. And I don't mean years. I mean millennia. I mean for all of eternity. We can make sure that our house, this house, is built to last. Now, I want you to see in Matthew 7:25. Sister Courtney, could you pull that back up for me? 7:25. We see a really important truth. The rains descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew on the righteous. On the ones that did the right thing, the storm still came. So that tells me something. It tells me life happens. It tells me that life is messy. It tells me that life is hard. So I want y'all to understand something. If you're going through something right now, you are going through the human experience. And everybody goes through things. It's not because of the devil. I'm saying the devil has places in our lives. But we give him far too much credit. We give him what he takes. Don't let him take not one more inch out of your life. I want you to understand something. We're going to go through some really difficult times in this life. That's just life. That's the nature of what we're going through. So, I want you to understand something. 100% guaranteed, your life will not turn out the way that you think it ought to. You're going to have something hard happen. I've said it like this, and you all probably know what I'm going to say. There's three types of people that are in this room right now. Three types. Either you're about to go through a storm, you're going through a storm, or you're coming out of a storm. That's it. because storms are going to happen in this life. You're going to have to deal with things. You're going to have to experience things. There's going to be troubles that come when we follow the Lord, but there's going to be troubles no matter what. So as storms come and your life gets turned upside down, the only thing that truly matters during those times is where your foundation is built on. Because if you are built on the rock, the winds are going to come, the rain's going to come, the floods are probably going to come, and you're going to be able to stand. If your house is built on Jesus, if your life is built on something that's bigger than you, you're going to make it. But if you build your house on your retirement fund, you build your house on the living that you make, on the family that you have, you build it on your own knowledge or your own ability, I can promise you those things will fail because they're finite. I want to build my life on something that will last longer than me. And the only thing that I've ever found in this life is Jesus. Only Jesus. So today, if you have not built your house, this life that we live on Jesus, let me introduce you to a man who can. Let me introduce you to a person that lived and died and rose again. And there's only one that I've ever found that's ever done that, that has conquered death, hell, and the grave. And his name is Jesus Christ. I want to tell you something. If you look inside of my life, you will see heartache. If you will look inside of my life, you will see pain. Let me give you an example. Man, on Facebook the other day, I didn't realize it's Deanna's 10-year anniversary. And I'm like, you all are like, y'all been married longer than that. No, you don't understand. 10 years ago, Deanna, they thought she had cancer. I say they thought because we found out in the midst of it that our God moved. So 10 years ago, amen. Yeah, I want to give God praise. We're going to praise him all day over that. But I want you all to understand that 10 years ago, Deanna, this time of year, we work in schools, people get sick, right? We got a lot of teachers in here. We got a lot of people who work in schools. We got a lot of people wiping noses and wiping other things, and you know what I'm saying? So you're going to get sick sometimes. So Deanna got sick, and she had pneumonia. So they did a chest x-ray. In that x-ray, they saw something, not here, here, in her kidney. And they said, this doesn't look right. Let's check this out. And so we go and we have an MRI, we have a CAT scan, we do a whole battery of tests, and you hear the word that you never want to hear, especially when you're 36 and have two daughters that are starting kindergarten. Or were you all in first grade? I can't remember. Huh? Well, young daughters. Near cancer. And it got real. I want you to know that. We cried. We thought. We wrestled. But more than that, we trusted and we prayed. Because what you all know about Deanna, I don't have to tell you, but there's people here that don't know her, is that she's trusted Jesus for a long time. 30 plus years now, she has followed Jesus with everything that she's had. And so when life happens, you pray and you grab the hand of the Master. And so that's what we did. And we prayed and prayed. And you know, through that whole situation, Deanna had faith like I've never seen. She prayed that the doctors would go, we don't know what happened. It's not there anymore. But that's not her story. She had surgery. She has 9/10 of a kidney, so don't ask for one. That's all she's got on that side. She's not giving that up anymore, okay? But the thing about it is she trusted, and it was really hard surgery. And the doctors came back and they said, we don't understand this. We've never seen anything like this. They don't even have studies about this. It seems that when you were a baby, when you were being formed in your mother's womb, I keep reminding myself that that's Psalm 139 tells us that I knew you even before you were created, right? When I formed you in your mother's womb, the Lord had created her with uterine cells inside of her kidney for some reason. And I believe that it's truly because those doctors needed to know who Jesus was. But they came back and they said, we've never seen anything like this. You don't have cancer. You're going to be fine. This is not coming back. This was something that only God could have done. And so, our foundation was strong, and Jesus brought us through. But even if it was cancer, our foundation was strong, and Jesus would have brought us through. But I sure am glad that I've got Deanna. I sure am glad that she was my example of how we are supposed to go through a storm like that. You know, if we look at Ephesians 2:19 through 22, and maybe you're going through some things right now. Look at this. This is what you can build your life on. Now, therefore, ye are no more strangers and foreigners to God, but fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God, and are built upon the foundation of the apostles and the prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone, in whom all the building fitly framed together grows unto a holy temple in the Lord. Listen to this. In whom ye also are builded together for a habitation of God through the Spirit. So here's the thing. God is indwelling us. If you build your house the right way, he'll come and sup with you and you with him. That's what it says in the Word. It says that if you build your house on the Lord, he won't leave you by yourself. He'll come and be with you. I need a God that'll come and be with me. I need Jesus to come and be with me because that's the only way that my life works. Because I know that I mess things up. I know that I do things wrong. But if I have Jesus, I know he will be with me and save me each and every time that I need him. I hope I'm not the only one like that. I need him more than I need my next breath. I need him all the time. Do you? Because if you don't know that, he will stand with you through. The Bible says the gates of hell will not be able to prevail against you if you stand with Jesus. So I don't know about you, but that's where I'm headed if I don't have him. So I need Jesus. I need him to go with me all the way, because if he's not with me, I'm not going to make it. Maybe that's you. Maybe you realize that you've got some things going on inside of your life that you've got to deal with. See, the thing about it is we all know that we've fallen short. We all know we make mistakes. We all know that things don't go the way that we think they should go, right? We establish that, I think. Here's the thing. If you recognize that and you don't do anything about it, then you're like that foolish man that built his house on the sand. You're just saying, I'm gonna believe that it'll be okay. I don't got that much faith. But when we build our house on the rock of Jesus, on his principles and his teachings, friends, the winds will blow, the floods will come, and you can be safe and secure in the arms of him for all of eternity. I truly believe that. I truly, truly believe that. I've got some scriptures that I want to share with you, okay? Christ became the cornerstone of our life. He's the center of my life. And when the storms come, we're ready. Are you ready? I pray that you are. Listen to these scriptures in Psalm 18, verse 2. It says this, "The Lord is my rock and my fortress. He's my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust. He is my buckler," which means he is my shield and the horn of my salvation. "And he is my high tower that I can run to." Listen to this. Psalm 95, 1 says this. It says, "Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation." You wonder why we worship the Lord, because we know who he is. I know that I have a redeemer. I know that I have a firm foundation and that he will never let me down. If that doesn't get you fired, I got goosebumps just thinking about that. I get tore up. Y'all seen me when I worship, I get loud. I get loud because I want him to hear me. I get loud, I raise my hands because I know that he sees my praise, and not just that, he inhabits the praises of his people. He wants to be here with us. Look at the next one. Let's go, Sister Courtney. Psalm or 1 Samuel 2:2, it says, "Therefore, there is none holy as the Lord, for there is none beside thee, neither is there any rock like our God." I can tell you this, Jesus and his commands are the rock. They're the rock that you can build your life on. Only Jesus can withstand and take us where we want to go. He's the only one. So today, friends, I just want to offer you Jesus. That's my offer today. Maybe this life isn't what you thought it would be, what it's cracked up to be. You know, it's not. You've heard people say, when life gives you lemons, make what? That don't work. I don't have the sugar to make it taste good. Because every time that I try to make something, it's bitter and wrong. But when life gives you lemons and you take it to Jesus, he can make lemonade. He can make something good out of something that's broken. The Bible says that he trades beauty for ashes and strength for fear. That's what Jesus can do. He can take something broken and he can put it back together and make it more beautiful than it was when it first was assembled. That's what Jesus does. There's a couple more scriptures that I want to share, and then I'm going to quickly get out of the way. Like I said, when things are broken, he can fix it and make it even better. James 1, 2 through 4 says this. It says, "My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations, when you have things that go wrong, knowing this, that the trying of your faith, it works patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire and wanting nothing." What that means is that you can be whole again. You know, Brother Eric talks about all the time when he was a little boy looking up at the cloud to knowing that there was a God and everything was right. You can have that feeling again. I truly believe that. You can have a feeling of peace and comfort and hope, but it only comes in Jesus. And the winds will blow, and the floods will come. But there's peace in the center of the hurricane. That's the way that I've always seen it. There's an eye, right? So in the midst of all of that, that's Jesus. Jesus can be your joy and peace. So what do we do with this? That is literally on my note sheet. What do we do now? Friends, if you don't have Jesus, you need him. He's the only thing that I've ever found that is worth trusting my life in. The only thing. the only person, the only entity, whatever you want to call it. Jesus, he will never leave you and he will never forsake you. He will go with you all the way until the ends of the earth. That's what he tells us in his word. Matthew 28:20. Look it up. Don't take my word for it. There's one more scripture I want to share with you. Psalm 62:6. And I'm going to ask Deanna or I'm going to ask David, my brother-in-law David, to come and sing an altar call for me. Would you do that? Psalm 62:6 says this, he only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense, and I shall not be moved. Friends, I'm going to ask you to stand with me, and I want to ask you, if you do, when you stand, could you just close your eyes for me?